Hi, I'm Kevin Hogan, president of Rock Island Auction Company. Welcome to our last sale of 2018, our November 30th, December 1st, and 2nd sale. I've been calling it November just so I can remember. We've had an exceptional year in 2018. We've handled some extraordinary individual consignments and some of the finest collections put together over the last three-quarter century. When you talk about the Dick Hammer collection, you talk about the Alan Coors collection, you talk about the Robert M. Lee collection, you talk about the Bob Peterson collection, Al Mackey collection, it's endless. But those are just names. And the pieces speak for themselves, whether it's Colts, Winchesters, U.S. military, high-end sporting, you're gonna see this is a special auction. But without further ado, we generally know that what videos we're gonna do on these great guns, these great individual guns, these genre-specific guns. You'll see us do two or three or four videos on Winchesters and Colts, sporting guns. It's a seminal moment for antique and collectible firearms. It's a seminal moment for our auction company, and this video is important to me. I've been thinking about doing this for a long time. I'm very excited about it because there are three world-class guns here. And we try to be creative and think conceptually. And you know, how do we approach selling three American 19th century best quality guns? And when you think of best quality guns, yes, of course, you typically think of English shotguns and double rifles from the likes of Boss, Purdy, Hound & Holland, Wesley Richards. But I think it's an underrated term to apply, and it should be used more with American arms, specifically 19th century American arms. And so the other concept too is to approach it as from a point of, you know, blue chips of 19th century American firearms and their competitors. We have a Winchester, a Savage, and a Marlin, and they competed. And just like anything, whether it's Coke or Pepsi, Dodge or Ford, and the gun business, every business is competitive. And so here is a extraordinarily unique opportunity. It's a rare opportunity, it's a fun opportunity to look at these three competitors, not just in the mechanical design of their product, but in their embellishment of and what they consider their best quality gun. We've used the phrase, not all art is framed, and indeed not. And these guns speak to that in volumes, in absolute volumes. You also talk about guns as a investment class asset. And why not? Because I think these guns can be looked at just like fine art, and that's how we're gonna look at these guns. That's how I'd like to talk to you about them today. I didn't know where to start because I'm probably be bouncing around a little bit, but again, I think it's, you know, based on the artwork that is here, we're gonna approach it a little bit differently. So we're gonna start here with the Marlin 1893, and we'll just, you know, we'll start with the barrel and we'll just work our way back. And again, we're going to bounce around, but when you compare best quality guns for Marlin, so Marlin did grades for engraving 1 through 10, and they did a special designation after 10. Their wood carving, similar to Winchester, they did A through H, exactly the same except opposite. So you want to go higher up in the numbers and further back in the alphabet, and that's what this gun is. So I'm going to roll it here. You can see beautiful original blue on the barrel, and then we'll get right into the engraving right here on the muzzle. Stronger, deeper, longer than you'll see on Winchester 1/1000s, but the subtle, beautiful accents of platinum and gold. That's the barrel. Takedown 1893, look at the takedown ring, gold inlaid. Start at the frame, gold inlaid. What's unique about Marlins is that you'll see a lot of them engraved on case hardening, a lot of them engraved and gold inlaid on case hardening. You don't see that with Winchester, you really don't. And I think it's one of the most luxurious compliments they have to one another, the case hardening and the gold, and how deep they went, because this scene, of the Glen Elk is in relief, I would say semi-relief, but I'll kind of roll it here in the light to see if we can pick up on that in the camera, and you can see how deep that is cut. And then just a real even, beautiful tone to the frame, you know, gold inlaid on the lever, gold inlaid on the hammer, I'm going to flip it and we can look at it on this side, but it's more of the same, more quality, same tone, same evenness, gold inlay, again, gold on the lever, gold on the hammer, beautiful case hardening, and then the wood carving. It's all there. We'll flip it. I'll flip it here on the butt. Look at the case hardening on the butt. Look at the screws. Again, gold inlaid, engraved. And, you know, this is an exhibition quality best Marlin 1893. It's photographed in steel canvas. And you can talk about price points, but we'll kind of go down the ring here, and they get more expensive as we go down. But for quality, how do you beat that for quality? You have factory engraving, case hardening, two precious metal inlays, wood carving, and now, again, going back to the similarities between Marlin and Winchester, a lot of the engraving is attributed to the Ulrich, specifically Conrad, and, you know, we know Conrad cut for Winchester. John kind of more or less dominated Winchester engraving. You'll see more of his work than you will with Conrad's, but they weren't designated to sign their work on Marlin, so it's extremely rare, although it has been observed, to see signed work by the Ulrichs on a Marlin. But again, the similarities are as interesting as the differences. And I may bounce back to the Marlin, but we're gonna move to the Savage. It's gonna move right down the line. We've been so lucky and so blessed to handle some extraordinarily fine guns, specifically 19th century American firearms. We've seen, again, engraving, gold inlaying, factory work. This Savage 1899, I consider it pound for pound the finest, certainly the finest 19th century American gun that I've ever handled. I won't say it's the finest one we've ever cataloged or sold. In my humble opinion, this gun is tangible perfection. It doesn't matter how good a gun is. You can always find, oh, you know, it's got a nick here. They didn't polish the muzzle. I think they should have polished the muzzle. There's a scratch here. It's in the wrong caliber. You know, I wish it was a full mag, not a half mag. You can do that all you want. But when you behold this gun, every medium of trying to give this gun justice, this video, close-up photos, close-up video, fall short to handling it personally. This gun is, it transcends, just like everything on here, but it transcends firearms. This gun is pure, living, breathing art. And I'll do the same thing. We'll start on the barrel. There's not much to talk about at the muzzle. Solid rib, hand stippled all the way down the length. And then we get here and we have gold inlaid bands and factory engraving. Subtle, but handsomely appointed, and I think that's what makes, it's not over the top. This gun is not over the top. It's just, it's so well done. And you get to the frame, and this gun was engraved by Savage engraver Enoch II, his masterpiece, no doubt about it, in full relief, in semi-relief, the most spectacular pair of bull moose on the right-hand side here. I'll roll it, but all the screw heads are engraved in gilt. I'll flip it up. You have a jeweled bolt, hand stippled. I'm going to flip it. One spectacular bull elk and a cow, a tiger here on the top. And I'm just going to roll it in the light. And again, most mediums of trying to give this gun any justice fall short. We flip it up here and have just the most spectacular wolf's head in full gold inlay. Beautiful border in high relief. We'll flip the gun around. I've talked to a lot of guys. They're pretty excited about these rams. Look at these rams. They're fabulous here on the underside. But the gun does not end. It is an absolute mountain of a gun. Everywhere from factory engraving here on the case hardened lever. I'm going to open it up, jeweled, hand engraved here on the trigger, hand engraved on the inside of the lever, gold gilt screws, and the wood carving is beyond extraordinary. We're going to flip it around. Again, engraved on the butt plate, gilt screws, engraved, stippled butt plate, exhibition quality wood, and the most spectacular wood carving you could hope to imagine. So if you find me fumbling and mumbling and trying to describe this gun, it's because it's a very difficult task to try and do this gun any sort of justice. It also has a wonderful pedigree. This gun was originally part of the Nathaniel Cushing Nash estate. Just to give you a brief history on the Nash family, they were some of the early pioneers, and you can't even call them pioneers in arms collecting, but they were more patron of the art of collecting American best quality guns. And some extraordinary guns have come out of that estate, anywhere from Holland & Hollands to Smith & Wesson's. A lot of great Smiths came out of the Nash estate, to three beautiful Savages. This is the highest grade. It's a Monarch grade. I probably should have mentioned that from the jump. But it's a Monarch grade Savage. It's the finest Savage there is known. And if you fancy yourself a fan of engraving and you think it's the highest art form like I do, you need to come see this gun. It is something else to behold. I think I've drooled on this thing long enough. I will move down to, I'm going to sound like a broken record here, but Grade 1 Winchester 1886, that's right. We sold the Winchester 1886 Grade 1 Big 50 out of the McCroskey Collection last auction for almost $1.2 million. And, you know, that gun had everything. It checked every box. Full octagon, full mag, 50 Express, Grade 1 engraving. And we have it again here. We've done the research. We've looked. We can identify four or five. One of the ones that we just sold, there's one that's maintained in a museum. Well, here's the other one, so that makes it three. And there's one other one that we can identify, but when it rains, it pours. And so the last thing we want to do is make something rare look common. Grade 1, 1886, it doesn't get any rare, it doesn't get any more desirable. And this gun's pretty unique. It's got a wonderful factory letter that actually letters as a new design in wood carving and engraving by Mr. Ulrich. And you can see that, the wood carving is spectacular because it's carving and checkering, which I think is a extremely, extremely handsome combination. And you see it not only on the buttstock and the pistol grip, but also on the forearm. Again, it's carved and checkered. We can't find that on anything else. The engraving pattern itself is atypical, specifically for John Ulrich, and this gun is signed by John Ulrich. You have the oak leaves, beautiful oak leaves, and again, gold platinum, designating the grade one, gold platinum. You have a ram, you have a bear, a wonderful bull elk here on the underside. I'm gonna flip it. A really cool scene of a bull moose and a cow. Again, there's just so many similarities. You have, an elk. We have elk, bull, moose on both of these guns, and you could see the engravers were fans of each other, and these guns were all done approximately at the same time, 1895 to 1905, and within that time frame, but they were all exhibition guns. And again, it's case-hardened on the hammer, case-hardened on the lever, desirable in its configuration, shotgun butt, takedown. All the grade ones are takedowns. They're all takedown guns. But to put these three guns on a table, and I got to talk about the highly finished arm catalog in front. So the grade ones are, again, they're well discussed. It was $250 worth of engraving and inlaying, $60 worth of carving. We talked about it on the Marlin, so it's the opposite. You have a grade one engraving and you have a carved wood, but this is more of a new design. But gold, platinum, absolutely spectacular. So again, as I said in the beginning of the video, all art is not framed, and indeed it is not. This is uniquely and distinctly American artwork by the best, by the absolute best, by American icons. And so the Savage hails out of the Robert M. Lee collection. The 1886 and the 1893 Marlin both came out of the same collection, and they're fresh. They are absolutely, absolutely fresh. So we're extremely excited to offer them in our upcoming December premiere sale. And they're just the beginning. Again, we talk about Winchesters a lot, but Savage, Marlin, U.S. military, German military, Colts, The Larry Jones collection, the Bob Peterson collection, Class 3s, it is here. So if you've never been to one of our sales or you want to come see one of these breathtaking masterpieces in person, mark it in your calendars. The last day of November, November 30th, December 1st and 2nd. Don't forget about our preview day, November 29th. We do a live preview all day. We do a party at night, and we make it fun. We make it fun. So for more information on this auction, visit our website, www.rockallenauction.com. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Hope to see you in December.